Now the preacher he went out walking. It was on one Sunday morn. Of course it was again his religion, but he took his gun along. He shot himself some mighty fine quail
and one little measly hare.
And on his way returning home, he met a great big grizzly bear. Oh, well, the bear sat down in the middle of the road, just mean as he could be. And the preacher, he commenced to shake, and he climbed up a simmon tree. Then the bear stood up, and he rolled his eyes, and he shook his ugly head. The preacher looked up to the skies, and these are the words he said. And these are the words he said. Oh, Lord,
he delivered Daniel from the lion's den. Delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, and then the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, so the good book do declare. Well, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't you help that bear. No, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't you help that bear.
Now the bear commenced to climb the tree, and that made the preacher sore. Preacher climbed still higher, till he couldn't climb no more. Just about then this limb gave away, and they both come a-tumbling down. And when that preacher began to pray, you could hear it for miles all around. Oh, Lord,
you delivered Daniel from the lion's den. Delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, and then the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, of the good book to declare. Oh, well, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't you help that bear. No, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't you help that bear.
Now they fought all the way down to the river, and it was a terrible fight. That bear was really laying it on, but the preacher, well, he was doing all right.
Yeah.
He dragged that beast right down in the water. It was three times in and out. Then the bear got loose, and he limped away. And the preacher, he began to shout, Oh, Lord,
we delivered Daniel from the lion's den. Delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, amen.
Now, Lord, it may not seem like much from where you sit up there, but the hardest job I ever done was baptizing that bear.
Yeah, the hardest job I ever done was baptizing that bear. Oh, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the lion's den. Delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, amen. The Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, of the good book to declare. Well, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't you help that bear. That's the story of the preacher and the bear.
Thank you.
up there, buddy. I'm not sure what you're doing.
It's a girl! happy if you mind to. Oh, all you gotta do is buckle down to it. Buckle down, buckle down, do it, do it, do it. Oh, you can't roller skate in a buffalo herd. You can be happy if you have a mind to.
I love you.
I got what you do for you.
And on the eighth day, God looked down on his planned paradise and said, I need a caretaker. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody willing to get up before dawn, milk cows, work all day in the fields, milk cows again, eat supper, then go to town and stay past midnight at a meeting of the school board. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody willing to sit up all night with a newborn colt and watch it die, then dry his eyes and say, maybe next year. I need somebody who can shape an axe handle from a persimmon sprout, shoe a horse with a hunk of car tire, who can make harness out of hay wire, feed sacks, and shoe scraps, who planting time and harvest season will finish his 40-hour week by Tuesday noon, and then painin' from tractor back put in another 72 hours. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody strong enough to clear trees and heave bales, yet gentle enough to yean lambs and wean pigs and tend the pink-combed pullets, who will stop his mower for an hour to splint the broken leg of a meadowlark. So God made a farmer. It had to be somebody who'd plow deep and straight and not cut corners. Somebody to seed, weed, feed, breed, and rake, and disc, and plow, and plant, and tie the fleece, and strain the milk. Somebody who'd bale a family together with the soft, strong bonds of sharing. Who would laugh, and then sigh, and then reply with smiling eyes when his son says that he wants to spend his life doing what Dad does. So God made a farmer.